It's kind of like a dream where it's real, but then you play it and you realize how real it is. Say like how it was created, or we just need something to fill this void in our movie.
Okay. What Fortball means to me is it's good times with the friends. It's good athletics, it's good exercise, you know, everyone should exercise. And, you know, sometimes it gets intense and rough, but that's just part of the game. And that's the way it's supposed to be played, you know, rough, physical, and you get to drink beer, and that's great, and I love it. That's Fortball to me. One of the most important rules that I can say for playing the game is you're scoring, the ball can't hit the coping, no copes, that's what it's usually called, and the ball goes into the net before hitting your opponent's goal area, it's called net no bien. That's about it, really.
I don't know the origins of the barn. I heard the barn, you know, one story is it rose from the ground, while the other story, it used to be like a cow and horse barn. You know, I think the truth falls between the two lines. I also have a and it was messy. It's not a clean place. Yeah, but it was good. It was a young woman from Argentina.
For Fortball. Well, it goes back to Germany where I was born. Discovered Pac-Man at age 1. By 5, I was a prodigy, getting the top score in the bars across the country. I decided to move to the United States to pursue my career in it. And then that brings me here. Mm-hmm.
beard.
When I first got into Fortball, I thought all these dudes were fucking crazy, but I just needed a place to stay, so I kind of went with the flow. Then I realized all these guys were just like me.
A washed up, dirty scumbag, thieving, sneezing son of a gun. But after Fortball, my life's finally changed, and I'm not ashamed of what I do anymore, which used to be nothing.
I was living the vagabond lifestyle, wandering the streets. Just like crab cakes.
Fortball made my life. It made a new life. Didn't change it. My life, I quit my life. I quit it, and Fortball created a new life. I was nothing at the company. They told me I was nothing, and then I found Fortball. And it's really hard to find Fortball. It's so many people pass by it every day, and they can't find it. It's hidden. It's a secret society. It's a life for people of Fortball. A lot of times where people get hurt, they'll fall off the edge. The net never stops them. And whenever somebody gets hurt, it's when the game usually ends. It's like, sometimes you fall in bottles. There's a lot of beer bottles down there. And everywhere, there's just beer bottles, and you usually get hit by something.
Shined brightly. He's one of the pioneers of Fortball, and I'm not looking forward to burying his body.
Who's my favorite Fortballer? There's so many. I have a least favorite, and that'd be the Moonbeam. And I don't miss him one bit. How'd he die? I heard he drank a handle of Clairvo and ate 3 packets of Pop Rocks. Apparently it was on YouTube for a while, just check it out. Do you guys mind if I light up? See, the fort is like the yin, and the ball is the yang of the whole game. So, it's also like the balance of life. Hence, Fortball is my answer to the problems that I've faced in my life.
What are your problems?
Anger. Well, I was heavy set. I weighed 350 pounds.
What the shit?
Trucked for a while. But mainly, I just weighed 350 pounds.
Turn it off!
Dreams? Well, yes. I always wanted to be an athlete, and Fortball gave me the motivation to change and become an athlete.
What do I think of the skitter? He's a fucking asshole.
Here comes the skids!
I don't know. I feel Fortball has changed ever since the skitter came on the scene. I mean, right now he's the guy to beat, but honestly, I don't trust him. He needs to be taken down.